Hello everybody, and welcome back to Assassin's Creed 3! Connor, jump, please. Connor! You asshole. Did I say to fall flat on your did I say to bang your head on the goddamn thing? No, I said grab, you can make grab and jump, grab. Whatever. Get this chest and then get this synchronization point.
With actual defenses.
As always, subscribe for more.
Some flamethrower turrets for the big damage, laser turrets to finish them off, and two layers of self-healing mending walls to keep out those fighters. To top it all off, we have straight sections, gay sections, and train stops for our repair train to come and visit when things need repairing. Now, what's the point of spending all this time designing and building a shiny new wall if it doesn't expand our territory? So, I hopped in the attack helicopter and expanded our territory. This is where our most powerful mod came into effect. And no, I'm not talking about the helicopter. I'm talking about the replacement of explosion cells with vine booms. Once it was all said and done, thousands of fighters had been laid off, evicted, and burnt to death, and our territory had been greatly expanded. Now, of course, let's build that wall. During construction, I had what some might refer to as a silly clown moment. To help speed things up, I'd been making good use of the jetpack, but the jetpack takes fuel. And
I ran out.
Walking all the way back was gonna take me ages, so instead of using my shit-ass legs, I handcrafted a Dodge Challenger in about half a second, and drove it back to base. Automating space science allowed us to research a lot of new things. New machines.
Growth facility grows biological specimens under a range of controlled conditions.
Grows biological specimens. Me. But most importantly, everyone's favorite weapon system.
Artillery. Baby. Makes you feel like a real man.
I guess the wall works pretty well. Now that the base perimeter had been secured, it was time to expand the factory to other worlds. Day 4. Seagull, the site of our next grand expansion.
Come on.
Seagull is a small moon rich in cryonite, the first resource that we can't just get on Norvus. And cryonite, we would be needing. So to get started, I fired up the creative world and spent a few hours creating. Cryonite presents a bunch of new challenges. First of all, it's not practical to put the processing plant on Norvus because cryonite ore only stacks at 20, which kinda makes moving it around a bit of a gigantic pain in the ass. But cryonite rods stack to 200, and each cryonite rod takes 10 cryonite ore, so that's 100 times better. Well, to make the rods, we need heavy oil, and the only way for us to get that is with oil processing, so we need to make some oil processing, and then we also need a way to deal with the light oil and petroleum byproducts, so we turn this into
synchronization, let's go. Hopefully there's a leaf pile that I can jump down into. Fuck it, just leap of faith it. No, there is not. That's a bad idea. Why would you not put a leaf pile there? Let me jump down, you fucker. You absolute douchebag. Fuck you. At every synchronization point, there should be something that I can leap of faith into. Thank you very much, you fucking moron. You fucking boss. Look at that. Wow, fuck. Ah, fucking bitch.
The even turbines, but the turbines only turn on when the solar panels don't produce enough energy, so we need a way of turning off the solar panels when we need to burn up the steam. And then that step that takes steam also produces water, so we need a way of making sure the water tank isn't full, and not to mention the fucking mountains of sand produced. Why is there so much sand? So yeah, it's already pretty complicated, and this is the simplest new resource. With all that being said, here's the blueprint. So, time for our next big venture. Before leaving, I had written out a comprehensive, exhaustive list of everything we would need. Except, of course, clip explosives, substations, construction box, and logistics bots. Hey, Forogor. I built a big solar field to power the base, sent it on the rocket with all the stuff I Forogor, and then sat back and let our good old botters do all the hard work. After an hour, the facility was done, and we had made our first cryonite rods.
Yes!
You know what? Let's get some travel music.
Spit something real. You know where I'm from, the sinks ain't clean. Y'all better wash yourselves. Can you even handle what I'm about to dish out? Nah. Better let this one soak in. Y'all. Take a sip of this, I'm as lit as any cup. Hey, gin and juice to the brim, nuff set. Packing heat, yeah, I'm somewhat of a hothead. Struck a deal with the devil, now I'm racking up debt. I made a dumb bet, mama don't get upset. I'm a cup of trouble, have you seen my mugshot yet? Forget a finger gun, grab a gat, drop dead. Backhand your boss, when I'm done I'll leave him jobless. Can't stop me, I'm running like a faucet. Cup runneth over, don't you ever try to drop it. Knock back a shot of this and then you'll kick the bucket. I can be drunk from, but cannot be trusted. Heads up, hit the deck, mug man. Get kicked to the curb and your head busted. This dirty bitch deserves a rough scrubbing. After doing these devilish deeds, goddamn. They say I need a clean, but nobody's here to rinse me. I'm overflowing, but my phones are almost empty. Beg for mercy, but they know it won't convince me. Put me on the shelf like hell, did you forget me? You'll never catch me crying over milk that's blue.
Oh my god, Connor, just climb the fucking thing!
Roller call themselves a monarchist. If you're one of them, then you gotta split. Ain't it show. Sorry, ladies, now, cause I gotta go. No one's catching me, cause I'm running free, just like everyone in my family tree. By land or sea, I live and die by your sense of greed.
I am the lonely wolf who stalks you in the night. I am the eagle circling up in the sky. My name is just a mask that I can hide behind. Born into revolution and I'm not taking sides.
Fucking God, get around it. Fuck, he's under the ground. My God, switch!
Welcome to the internet, come and take a seat. Would you like to see the news or any famous women's feet? There's no need to panic, this isn't a test. Just nod or shake your head and we'll do the rest. Welcome to the internet, what would you prefer? Would you like to fight for civil?
Oh, come on, I can't see!
Be horny, be bursting with rage. We've got a million different ways to engage.
Oh, that's such... Shut the fuck up! That's such bullshit, man! I pressed the thing! Fucking, that's such fucking bullshit, man. Fucking camera. Literally couldn't see fuck all. Because of the fucking camera. What are you doing, Con? fucking dumbass! How the fuck am I supposed to get in there? Let's blow it on up! And bye bye to your bot, to your explosives. Cool guys don't look at explosions. They blow things up and run away! I almost fucking probably died from that. Get out. Skip. Why can't it be under Indian command? Fuck you. Like the Patriots are any good, any
better than the British.
They're still fucking slavers. They still treat natives like fucking absolute garbage.
They blow things up and walk away. Oops, excuse me. They blow things up and kill your mom. Boom boom, bitch, boom boom. Let's go in. Let's go in and sell. Oh, this is a tailor. I should go back to what's his name? Pegleg, right? Pegleg, and give him those trinkets that I have. No, not that. I meant to fast travel. Oh, right, this way.
Got some more? Let's have a look then. More keepers! Good on ya! I see that's worth another letter.
I will be back for the rest.
14. Fuck's sake. Fuck's sake, Peggy. This one's closer. I'll do that one first.
I never returned. I'm very sick. What if she's hurt?
I will find her.
The dog might help track her down. He has a good nose. Come on, boy! She has been gathering evening primrose almost every night. She is obsessed with the oil it yields. It's all going to stop now. I don't understand why she wants so damn much of the stuff.
Maybe it's good to use. Good to work with? I don't know. Maybe it smells good.
We should split up to cover more ground.
Don't ever split up in a forest, you fucking idiot. Looks like she ran from something. Yep, bear. You're welcome.
Thank you so much, Connor. Thank you. I don't want to think what might have happened if you had not arrived. I saw some primrose growing there, and the bear just came charging at me.
Why are you gathering primrose?
Well, Warren and I have been trying to conceive a child for a long time now. I read that evening primrose encourages fertility.
Rubens! Are you all right, my love?
I'll be fine. Thanks to Connor.
Thank you, Connor. Once again.
Here you go, lad. Now, if you don't mind, I need to go get that bear. Never mind.
That was a really good one.
Excuse me, why the fuck are you... Could you go the fuck away, Prudence Promise? I've already done you. Yeah, and I guess that's a bug that they never fixed. Where do you think you're going, mate? Connor, jump, you fucking re. Good night, dumbass.
What's the trouble, Connor? So you're here past chasing a man.
He was trying to rob your home. It has been dealt with.
What? For women? Is everyone all right? You should have been there.
What?
I told you to head back. I didn't need you.
Since when is a skinny runt like you safe out in the bush alone?
If Diana's hurt, I knew where you'd be the one.
They're fine, you idiots. Yay! Can now produce level 2 goods. Hooray! Yippity-yay! Let's go. Another homestead mission, eh? Enough, you two idiots.
You will miss
The fuck is wrong with the textures? Stop using spell, use fucking a minute. Just use the numbers.
Are you not angry, Godfrey?
Me? Not at all. Dennis just got himself a temper, and I won't let him get away with it. It's really no trouble. He'll calm down. The run couldn't do much damage anyway.
Does this happen often?
I was just telling Lance how I can set a calendar by these events. It's really not a worry, Connor, but I appreciate your concern.
Connor, they're idiots. They'll fight and argue, whatever. So what? Level 3 goods! Hooray! Hell yeah. Hey dog!
I'm ready to go to bed.
Good for you.
Good for you,
like
ready
I said. Whoop de doo da, so what? Hold on, I need to see the controls. Controls. No, not that. Controls. That is a pain in the ass, bro. Such a pain. Welcome to Minority Park. Fuck minorities, fuck yous. Wow. Fast travel to there and do this homestead mission. Homestead thing. I didn't see that fast travel point. So, who am I helping out this time? G'day. What can you do for me, mate?
Thank you, my friend. They had a little too much beer and didn't like the sound of my voice. I was only talking to that girl.
Your accent is unfamiliar. Where are you from?
North of here. Province de Quebec.
And what brings you to Boston?
I am a miner by trade, but it's hard to find work. People don't listen to me because of my accent.
It might be our meeting was fate. I hail from a village just a few miles north of here. There are the beginnings of a mine. I do not know what is in there, but you might find what you are looking for within.
I'll come have a look. If there is something good, maybe we'll talk, eh?
Later. Love you, Ma. Have a good sleep. We got your shit? Fuck my eyes. Oh, fuck off. For fuck's sake, Connor. Royal pistol, eh? Hooray. Ooh, money. Let's continue on watching Martin Cedar Pants, baby. Let's go. Blah. Shut the fuck up, Caleb.
I built another rocket, another landing pad, and flew myself back home. And there we go, boys. Cryonite was now available. The first thing we needed it for was making utility signs. So I hooked it up to a delivery cannon, went back into space, stuck down a bunch more machines, and before I knew it, utility science was done. Yes! Finally, we could research logistics system, and the factory could grow even larger. Day 5. Time for the factory to grow even larger. Using our new logistics chest, we began reconstruction of our space base to use the bus design, and tragically, in the process of building our new bus, this happened. Oh no. Funnily enough, this train had has not been touched for over 20 hours and was still spinning. I finished up the startup by us and rebuilt the science production to make a respectable 60 science per minute. Utility science was done, now it was time for production science. Production science uses vulcanite, and so it was time for more creative work. Vulcanite, like cryonite, has its own set of unique challenges. First off, vulcanite stacks to 20, so once again we want to make it into vulcanite blocks. Vulcanite ore goes into pulverizers, gets pulverized into crushed vulcanite, enriched vulcanite, and even more fucking sand. The crushed and enriched vulcanite are then used in centrifuges with some added sulfur, which produces even more enriched vulcanite through a feedback loop. The enriched and crushed is then sent to industrial furnaces, where it's combined with water and petroleum, which makes our final product vulcanite blocks and some steam, and the steam is put through a condenser turbine, which converts most of it back to water. Now this process is fairly complicated, but what makes it particularly difficult is the fact that planets with lots of vulcanite also tend to be waterless. No water means we can't easily make the sulfur or petroleum, so those need to be shipped in. Or do they? Since we now have access to cryonite, we can also freeze the water and ship it around that way. Water ice can stack to 200, and each ice holds 100 water, so every stack is 20,000. This is quite a good solution, because ice is almost free, and we don't have to ship any barrels, which is good, because barrels suck. While I was sorting all this out of my head, Ben joined the creative world and decided to build some plutonium reactors.
Uh-huh.
Of course, seeing as we were in a creative world and had access to whatever we wanted, things very rapidly went off the rails.
Plutonium atomic bomb. All right, Martin, where the f*** are you?
Don't shoot this, please. Oh my god.
Oh my god.
Holy shit.
It's gonna shoot fast, okay? Let me do it.
Oh, there I go. God. Jesus Christ. My screen is just white.
What are you... What's with all the worms, Ben?
Alright, Martin, in game blueprints, if you ever need... If you ever need a block of 23,000 worms, it's just fucking there.
Oh my god, that's a lot of worms.
Worms. That's what that is.
Back in the game, we got a few things ready for our vulcanite expansion and had a look around at the star map when we noticed an interesting structure in the asteroid belt. Day 6. Agni, our chosen destination for vulcanite processing. But first, more creative world to try and wrap my head around cargo rockets. Okay, it's been a few hours, but did you wrap your head around cargo rockets?
Nope.
This large amount of factorio I've been doing was definitely getting to me. My initial plan of being efficient called for a schedule, short breaks every hour or two, frequent meals, but all of that went out the window once I started actually playing.
Heinz beans.
Right now, but I'm almost done with my new smelter setup, and I think I know which is more important. This game really is crack. Anyway, I still had a job to do, and today it was to go to Agni and get some goddamn vulcanite. I loaded up a rocket, this time remembering to bring the stuff I forgot last time, and flew over to our next big adventure. Big-ass solar panel, stuck down 10,000 more accumulators because the day-night cycle is quite long, and once again, sat back and let the botters do all the hard work. And after a few hours of bringing more stuff from Norvus, the blueprint was built and vulcanite was finally being processed. So I took it back home, laid a setup to make iron ingots, loaded it all on delivery cannons, built even more space machines, and what do you know, production science was automated. Oh my god. It only took 82 hours. Production science let us unlock a bunch of cool stuff. Better inserter configurations, beacons, bigger bot cargo capacity, code bricks enrichment, and best of all, incendiary artillery shells.
Jump over, you fucking idiot.
And with that, I quit Factorio and went out with my friends to a nightclub. You know, for efficiency. Day 7. After a rather solid night out, leaving the club when the lights came on at 4 a.m. and getting home at 5, I went to bed, got nowhere near enough sleep, and hopped back on Factorio. However, as you can probably imagine, the powerful hangover I was battling with left me playing Factorio like a complete brick. So, I wasn't going to do anything complicated. Just some simple upgrades. Productivity module 3s, some Covarex processing, concrete production to fuel my incredible cement addiction, some upgrades for the science setups, and finally, designing and building a nuclear reactor that takes no inspiration whatsoever from this one by Zisto. Oh, no, they just happen to be quite similar, for no particular reason. I completed the day with some copper smelting expansion. Hey girl, are you a construction worker? Because you are building.
It just makes sense. It just makes sense, though.
And right before I went to bed, I found this wonderful hidden text plate.
A lose.
Day 8. Our resources are running low. And that space we claimed on day 3? Well, I think it could be larger. Right now, we need more copper. And while there's a little bit within our walls, there is much, much more. Just a little outside of them. I think you see where this is going. It was time to expand our territory once again. I laid out a plan for a new wall, trying to use as much water as possible. So what's the point spending all this effort clearing out this territory if our wall is outdated and shit? So I hopped back into the creative world and built a wall, version 2. For our new wall, I would be using some of our new upgrades. Each wall segment would have an artillery turret loaded with incendiary shells, but the main difference is in the train stops. The old system was dumb, but the new system is less dumb. This totally fully necessary big blob of combinators briefly complex these chests and cause the train when supplies are low. The main advantage of the new system is that once the station is built, the train will automatically come by, unload the materials and construction bots, and the bots will build the rest of it for me. The flamethrowers also now use napalm since... why not? Anyway, for us to actually build these walls, we would need to clear out a lot of fighters. So, I hopped back in the attack helicopter and got to work on our next grand expansion. First wall segment had been placed, and thousands of fighters had been sacrificed for it to happen. I quickly stuck down some copper outposts, and the factory's blood could flow yet again. Day 9. I wasn't done. Gentlemen, it was time to build the rest of the wall. To build it, I'd have to clear out thousands and thousands of fighters. So, wanting to do things efficiently, I ran some tests. The attack helicopter was great, but it needed lots of rockets, and it had health, so it could die. And while it was very fast, it could be faster. Introducing the Flying Fortress, one of the vehicles of all time. More health and faster speed. Surely this would be better than the helicopter. No. The Flying Fortress is an airplane, and airplanes have this little quirk where if you go below a certain speed, they go, I don't want to fly anymore, and they land. So, inevitably, while delivering high explosive rockets from the safety of my plane...
Run away.
...by an angry mob. Next up was our new incendiary artillery, which proved to be much more effective. Using manual targeting, I could clear entire giant nests in a few seconds. Even better, I could use the helicopter to get to an island, stick down the turrets, and rain death behind an impervious barrier of water. This was great, but it could be even better. Introducing artillery shells that are atomic bombs. Our arsenal was perfected, the blueprints were ready, and Operation Troopship was a go. About 13 hours of pure killing, paving, and building to get here. But it was definitely worth it, because safety and security had finally, for real this time, been achieved. Day 10. With our borders more secure than ever, it was time to continue on our galactic conquest. Ben and I, again seeing that spaceship in the asteroid belt, decided to hop in a rocket and go get it. Alright, here it is, Ben.
Cool guys, okay. Don't look at explosions. They blow things up and walk away.
So cool. It's a cum wagon.
Yeah.
Riding on the high of our successful bootstrap spaceship experience, we scoured the star map for anything else interesting. And we found something interesting. An alien pyramid structure poking out of the ground on the surface of Agni. So, Ben and I headed over to Agni to take a look. There it is. Okay, 3, 2, 1, go. Well, shit. Thanks once again to Offer.
Why? I haven't done anything.
Down below, link in the description and the video.
Oh my fucking god, Connor, just go to the right, cunt!
Good evening. In this video, we fly to space in Victoria. That's right, boyos, we've installed the Space Exploration Mod, which allows us to build a rocket, strap in, and launch ourselves into the great beyond to explore, expand, and conquer. Gentlemen, our subjugation will be vast, and our profits will be vast. For us to win, we don't just launch a single satellite like vanilla Victoria. No, discuss far too easy. Cringe. To win, we must build an interstellar spaceship and fly it at the speed of light. Will we achieve this lofty goal? Will we
synergistically motivate client-oriented initiatives?
Will it be overrun by the hordes of angry environmentalists, or will our gross incompetence cost us everything? Joining us on this journey are my employees, Ben and Tristan. So, let us begin. Day 1. Our journey began right here, which is precisely where our little spaceship had crash landed.
I found the recipe!
From here, it was up to us and our entrepreneurial spirit. So, we began work. We built some drills to mine ore, furnaces to smelt the ore into plates, and plates into more drills, more ore into more plates. The factory.
This is gonna be a really good pistol to use. Bang, bang, bang! And that fires 3 bullets at once, so 3 dead people. For jail keepers. Good to know, but whatever, I don't really care. Anyway, I'm gonna leave this episode here. As always, subscribe for more if you're new. And share my channel and videos with your friends. And let's get that sub goal to 22, shall we? Peace out, everybody. Bye.